The Tube. Tyler here, Chico Crypto, coming to you live on a surprise Friday live stream. I'm sure you guys are surprised. Shouldn't be doing a live stream today, but I am. And the markets are hitting that 11K level. A little bit of a rejection so far, but nothing substantial. Nothing to wreck the longs. A little bit, but nothing in a manipulation sense. Welcome, all viewers. I'm sure a lot of you are excited. I haven't talked about the Uni airdrop. I think it's at like $6 right now. So if you would have held, that's a pretty substantial airdrop for most crypto users. Controversy. Yes, there's sound. Stop lying. Yeah, I'm live today. Unisox, aha. Louder, please. I'll turn it up a little, but I'm not gonna let it get too loud. Some of trying to work right now. Farm Uni, don't buy. Well, yeah, it's a surprise live stream, and I just wanna ask everyone who's joining this live stream, because I got kicked off of Twitter for no reason. Follow me on my social outlets. I'm on Uptrend, decentralized platform. I'm on Facebook. Don't follow my old one. I'm sure a lot of you have followed my old one, Chico Crypto. Well, people couldn't share any of my posts on there, and I don't know why. So I created a new one, and you can share my posts. Someone tried yesterday, so follow that one. It's at CryptoCryptZero. I'm going to get the Chico Crypto once they allow me to delete my old one, but Facebook's Facebook. Takes 14 days, whatever. And I'm also on Instagram. All the links can be found description of the video and on my homepage. So give me a follow, please. So Bitcoin, why do I think we are going to, bounce? Well, let's first talk about the bearish. What's bearish about Bitcoin right now? Well, Bitcoin interest is at a low, you guys. Like, low where it's never been this low when we're above 10,000. That's what's weird right now. I mean, Google search trend, I know there's other parts of the world, China, that use... Oh, Austin, thank you so much, man. I appreciate your tip. I know there's other places of the world, besides Google Trends, but the trend is going to be similar. From Google. Google is a pretty global platform. And it's at a low where we've never been at this price level. It's crazy. And then what's the highest it's ever been, to me, I think it's funny, is CME Gap. CME Gap is the highest interest on Google Trends. So people know that 9.6, 9.8K CME Gap. Austin, thank you. I want to, stop talking so I can appreciate your tip, man. But the CME gap, I'm not a full believer in. I've made a couple videos. I don't think we're touching it this time. I think this gap is the bear setup because there are a lot of bearish whales that made a ton of money on the few times we've went down. A ton of money I'm talking about. And I think they want to set those guys up. And that's why I do believe there's a chance that we could possibly take another little bit of a dip before the real breakout. Just another setup, Oh, Bobby Sam, do as promised. Thanks for being the GOAT and putting me on Uniswap, bro. I appreciate it, man. I'm sure you did well. My pleasure, man. I hope a lot of people did well. I was one of the first people to cover Uniswap, actually. Nobody was using it when I covered it. I think the volume on it was like 14, 15 million. It was before Coinbase made their big dive into it. 8 months ago? Yeah. So I appreciate that, man. And I hope a lot of you guys did well. That's what the channel... I wish I could do a Uniswap type airdrop. Maybe Chico Coin eventually, but... Oh, wow. Thank you, Dr. Ed. Congrats on the John Wolpert tweet. Yeah, my buddy sent me that. That is very awesome. Wow, just a $20 tip. I can't even read a name. It's just a big old $20 tip. But yeah, that's that gap. And some people are going to say, even if we don't hit it, that we touched it because there are little touches. I just hate the CME gaps. I mean, it's such a wide gap. What if we touched like the middle of it, you know, with a little tiny candle? You know, does that count? What counts? You know, it's stupid. I think it's completely stupid. It's just for the TA people. Something to give them to talk about, you know. Willie Woo, he is a big trader, very prominent, he's a whale, definitely. And he said, I'd say there's a fair chance the CME gap may not get filled. So far, it's been front run for liquidity. Every dip has been snapped up. If so, it'll be the first CME gap on daily candles that remains unfilled. Yeah, that's good to me, seeing him tweet that. And I personally have a feeling the same thing. It's a setup. Total setup. Retail setup. Retail whale setup. Because there are a lot of retail whales. There's actually probably more powerful retail whales right now than institutional whales. I'm not joking you. The institutions are trying. And they're trying to set some of these bearish retail whales up.
Ricky Bobby!
Hey, he wasn't first, but he sure isn't last. I appreciate that tip, man. And then just another $3 tip with no name. I don't know if YouTube's just glitching out because I've never seen that before or what. But thank you. Loop ring. I do like loop ring. Vitalik likes loop ring too. A little stuff went down with Neo, but Neo's getting their DeFi flamingo. I'd stay away. So why do I don't think it's going to like go down, like really down, like 9.6K down, CME gap down? We might, you know, go a little bit farther down, but I don't think that far before the next bump, because Tesla, look at 515, it got up to you on some futures exchanges. Yeah, baby, that's the crypto tech stonk. I mean, I wouldn't doubt Tesla is one of the first actual stocks to transfer over to the blockchain. I don't doubt it for a second. But yeah, you can correlate crypto, Bitcoin, and Tesla and the movements of them pretty closely. I mean, Tesla's very volatile. It was down at 320 earlier this week, and now it's at 444, 441. And last week, when it was at its low, I was like, buy that shit. Buy that shiznit. Because battery day, I mean, it was obvious. I mean, the big event is coming. One that's, I believe, things are going under the radar for. I mean, everyone's thinking it's going to be the million mile battery technology. I think it's going to have more to do with what really matters is trading, you know, revolutionizing how energy is moved and traded. That's what I believe is coming. We'll see. There's, if you guys watch my video, you guys know my research. Ooh, uni at 635, nice. Oh, Dear Dick, thank you, brother, I appreciate it, man. BZRX is rebranding? Oh. Yikes. So, battery day, yeah, that was a good stuff, if you couldn't tell. But, Tesla, yeah, from my video, bounced from like 350 upwards of 450 now. So, yeah, I bought some Tesla, I'm not gonna lie. I hope, I mean, I don't hope some of you guys did, but I think it was a good call. So tech stonks, you know, that's the definite reason why basically I believe Bitcoin's going to bounce, because tech stonks are going to be having a green day today, in my opinion, to close the day. The markets are, and that means a bullish taste is going to be left in, you know, the market's mouth, and it's going to trickle down into cryptocurrency for the weekend. Might have a slight dip today, but over the weekend, I think we're going to be bullish come Monday too. But other bullish things for Bitcoin is the hash rate. I mean, look at that, exploding back to new highs. And I think a lot of this does have to do with American operations, not only American, global operations with outside of China going online, and the steep competition that China is feeling from that. So they're also pushing online too. And that's only good for Bitcoin. Global hash rate wars are good news. Competition is good. I'd like to see more competition in the mining, you know, chip design industry. Not the actual just mining of the Bitcoins, but the design of the machines, because that's pretty much China controlled right now. There are a few companies that aren't China, but not many. Hey, what's up? Kevin B, is banned dead? No, banned is trading, but I never liked banned. I'm not a big fan of any Binance IEO project. I mean, some might have some pretty good tech. Matic is probably the best that has come out of that. But you get into the situation with Binance having a large chunk of their tokens, which is hard to get away from. I mean, I've heard of project after project being like, that's the reason we're pretty much dead right now, because Binance. So unfortunate. So my personal opinion, what could happen to the Bitcoin price? Small little dip. Maybe down to here. But by the weekend's over, we might be back to where we were, and then, you know, just some good TA for you guys. Hope you like that. But I've always wanted to show this. And it's a just trend of Bitcoin's price, you know. Back in the, when I first got involved, 2013, 2014, you know, this was basically, we got over. We shouldn't have got up here at this time, you know. We came back into basically equilibrium with where the price should be. Maybe a little bit where below right here. But then we started trending to where it should be. Right here again, we got where we shouldn't be. Trending. Right here we hit. I think this is where the price should have been at this state and time. Trending. Again, we just bubbled out. Trending. And, you know, something like that. So, I think we're more closer to the line right now. Where we're at, so that's good. Getting out of the, I mean, bubbles are bubble territory, but, and that's where a lot of money is made, but there's a lot of money lost on the way down for newbies who get, I mean, it sucks with crypto. It's a hard thing, because newbies usually get involved when the price is bubbling, and then they're the ones that buy at the top and get wrecked on the bear markets down, you know. I guess it's almost a rite of passage for crypto. You think Powerpool CVP is going to bounce back? Of course, I think any project pushing on layer 2 is going to push forward pretty significantly. Layer 2 is, you know, layer 2, it's the next, it's the way projects create something that isn't possible on Ethereum right now. A lot, I mean, the only thing that's possible right now on Ethereum is swapping of tokens, and even that's getting outrageous for people. If you want to try a game or anything, it's not going to work. Javier Zepeda, thank you, man. My man Chico, always at the bleeding edge of crypto. Appreciate all the time and effort you put forth to bring us the heat. Always bringing the heat, man. You know why? Hopefully this is up. Nope. Damn it. I took it down. Where'd it go? Well, I gotta search for it now. Because I wanted to do it. You know, this was supposed to be up. But I probably can't play the music, or YouTube will try to take me for...
Mufasa, you know we finally here, right?
Well, we...
It's Friday, it's Saturday, Sunday, what?
Oh, can't play the music. YouTube will try to take my ads away from me and give them to Mufasa. No, they won't even give them to Mufasa. They'll give it to, if they're going to give it to Mufasa, I'd probably do it. They're going to give it to the creator of the song. My opinion on Bree. Solid. It's similar, you know, to CVP. Not exactly, but governance, pooling, token, and I mean, I like that concept. That's the reason, you know, I'm looking at both of them. Yeah, Safe is coming back. We're actually going to talk about that. Where was I? So, this was weird. I have to point this out. Our Bitcoin is such a weird subreddit right now. I mean, you go do it. It used to be awesome. You go do it. It's dead. 28 comments in the daily discussion and garbage after garbage post. But this is one of the top posts. 1,314 upvotes. Governor Mark Gordon. Today, Wyoming became the first state to approve a banking charter for digital assets. This will allow those using digital assets like crypto to access reliable financial services, protect consumers, and allow businesses a way to safely hold digital assets. Okay. You can hold them safely yourself. And I mean, it's good for crypto. It's good for business for crypto. But it's kind of going backwards, and it's not needed. And I think I'm going to talk about that on Monday. I haven't finished my script and my research for Monday's video. But what I want to see, the next wave of things, is not, you know, scaling, of course, and stuff like that, because that's needed for payments, which is probably what I'm going to get into, because there's something... a project that has something built for this, but they're held back by the scalability. But what I want to see is payment rails, you know, ways to accept DAI, the stable coin, you know, not necessarily even a way to accept USDC, because that's backed by a dollar. We're going backwards again. At least DAI is backed by Ethereum collateral in CDPs. So it's keeping us within the crypto ecosystem. You know, if businesses are able to accept DAI, you know, a stable coin from crypto users, again, that keeps the business's value stable, not subjecting them to the fluctuations of Ethereum or Bitcoin, that's more realistic. But the DAI payment options are unrealistic right now because of Ethereum's transaction fees. So, again, xdai is something I think could be very valuable in the future. Short to midterm, long term. Oh, yeah, so this was awesome. I was super pumped, and if you're watching Johnny Wolpert, I appreciate the retweet. He said, blown away by the quality of reporting on this episode of Chico Crypto. Other than saying folks were appointed to some projects, anyone can step up to work on a project in the baseline. Couldn't find a single thing that was factually incorrect. So, yeah, unfortunately, I said baseline was pointed, but they are working on a piece of the baseline, which is cross-border, you know, making sure supply chains can do that. And as I showed in the video, Morpheus has that. But I'm super pumped about that. As in a Waynist, I like that name because it's like my kitty. As an enthusiast and as an enthusiastic follower of EWT, what do you think of smaller cap power ledger? Thanks for the great content. EWT all the way. Power ledger, I was a fan back in the day, but it's just been too long. And not the partners, you know. It's been a long time for EWT too, but they have... if you read behind the lines, whatever, you'll see EWTs actually have these a lot of pilot programs going on. They're just not very, I don't not want to say good about marketing about it, but they're just letting it kind of flow under the radar. Appreciate your tip, Wayness. Large Borb. Falcon Swap is coming in a few days, and we'll drastically reduce fees on Uniswap by aggregating orders before sending them. Oh, that's pretty awesome. I didn't know about that, Large. Good concept. I'm going to have to take a look. Whoa, NJ. I don't even know how much money that is, but thank you. It's like the red one, which means a lot, I think. No problem, man. I appreciate your tip. I wish it told me how much that was in USD, because then... Oh, Papa Whoop! I know Canadian money. Congrats on Morpheus. Hey, thanks, man. I appreciate it. Yeah, I'm liking trying to pull the best sponsors possible. I mean, with the bubbling markets, you get a lot of people that want to advertise, and there are some shitty projects willing to pay you a lot, so... I've tried to stay away from that. I mean, I've been offered a lot of money, but... So, yeah, Uniswap. Ba-bang, ba-bang. Let's go. Let's go. Hold that. Hold it. Hold it. Yeah. 600, it's getting up to where it should be right now, you guys. So, I mean, if you're thinking about... selling, I wouldn't hate you right now, because $613 million market cap with just the circulating supply of tokens is high, and there could be some bad news necessarily coming because some of the aggregators are wanting their tokens like 1 inch and stuff, and I mean it could cause a rift between a lot of these protocols if they don't get. I mean it's money, it's a lot of money. That they could use for development and stuff. So, I mean, there could be a boost in the circulating supply really soon. But that's just what I'm seeing. I mean, no financial advice whatsoever. But it was like a crypto stimulus, you know. Of course, you know, some people are selling and to buy on things like food, whatever, necessities. Some people are buying PlayStation. I saw that. putting pre-order down with their, but some people like who have built with Uni are using it to actually now build their platform out. So it was almost, you know, like a stimulus for these crypto projects, which is good. And that's why I almost think like Uniswap should give the tokens to, I don't know, because these 1 inch, they are already established. They have money, you guys. Some of these smaller projects, you know, they deserve it more. You know, do we want to see governance get into the hands of just some of their aggregators, which that will be the start? You have too high expectations on the average Joe retail's interest in BTC. They won't care until all-time high, maybe a lot later, like at the 50K price range. What do you mean? Oh, no. Dude, average Joe will care again. When? Oh, yeah, no. Average Joe will care again. I mean, we get up to 15, 16K. Interest is going to rebubble. I mean, not get to peak. But I think once we get right next to near all-time high, we're going to peak again. That's why I think these whales, they just need to do it. They need to do it. But I don't hate on them for delaying it a little bit. Albo T, thank you for the $20 tip, man. And to the moon for your tip as well. Love your videos. Am I still bullish on Unibright? Of course I am. I made the video yesterday. They are literally part of the reference implementation for the baseline protocol, you guys. So, you go to baseline documentation. Oh, there it is. Through the docks. I gotta have this. I was just looking at it yesterday. Might be an architecture. Oh, there it is. See, reference implementation. So, if you go into it, BRI 1, which is the reference implementation, libraries, I think it's in the SAP. Yeah. Unibrite. So, I mean, being part of, you know, the reference implementation is what everyone uses, you guys. I mean, it's what the developers reference to build off of. So, being part of that base reference is, yeah, that's pretty damn good. If, you know, things are going to happen, which I do think they will. Why Chainlink dumping like that? Because Chainlink being Chainlink. Stinky Link being Link, you know? Can't help it. Oh, yeah. So, yield farming, down a little bit. Hit a higher, 591. It's back. So I talked about it, you know, a great concept because it, you know, kind of incentivizes people to get insurance on their DeFi and yield farming positions, which is a good thing. But then there was some community split, but they have patched things or fixed things or have a path forward. Supposedly there is going to be a fork. Chef Insurance, the original person, is going to be forking cover to cover protocol, while I think the other guy is going to be continuing with safe. So there's going to be a one-to-one drop for holders. Good concept. I think Andre is still going to be helping with one person. I'm not 100% sure on that, so don't quote me on that. But good to see a bounce back, and just crazy to see, you know, what can happen to a coin in the matter of, I mean, this hasn't been out 7 days. 4,000, boom, boom, boom. It just doesn't know what to do. But good concept. You ever cruise for chicks in Oroville? What? Actually, I do. That's a good spot to pick up chicks at. Yes, I do. I appreciate that. Comment and your tip, Glenn. Shananwaz Jilani. How would I confirm the uni transaction on Argent? That's a good question. I mean, claiming on Argent's pretty simple, but I mean, claiming through Uniswap is pretty damn simple too. So, I haven't claimed on Argent, unfortunately, so I can't guide you on there. Appreciate your tip. Alan. Oh yeah, so stake. In buy territory, in my opinion. I know some of you guys get sick of me talking about the same coins over and over, but I like stuff because I like it. I believe xdai is one of the mid to long term scaling solutions for Ethereum. It's going to be where a lot of things are going to be pushed. Not necessarily full, you know, blockchains, the full, you know, like Aragon, they're already talking about pushing some of the things onto xdai. A few other projects. But this, you know, this is good regarding xdai. So, Power Pool. So Power Pool is in their gamma round right now, and initially they said they're going fully with Matic. But then all of a sudden they decided, hey, we're actually going to go with another layer too, xdai. And this was tweeted just a few days ago. Gamma round is started. We face some issues with Matic network, but no need to worry. We're solving it right now. So, issues. No issues with xdai. xdai working flawlessly. And if you see what's going on, I know this isn't a ton of money, but this is what is happening, and you're going to see something big happening soon. So, 55 million basically locked up, and or 55,000, not peanuts. But we have, you know, been jumping day after day. It's because a lot of people are testing right now. But there is some information that a bigger project might be going live. And this partnership has been going down for longer than I realized. So a guy in my group actually dropped the information that said xdai in their Discord, Acropolis is probably going to be dropping on their chain. So Acropolis and their Delphi, they have like 23 million locked up right now. So 500,000 locked up, you know, on xdai. If they go live, that's 23. That's a freaking massive jump. And we could see that from a lot of different ones. Power Pool, of course. So it's just the beginning for xdai, in my opinion. But yeah, Acropolis, this partnership between them, you know, working together all the way back in April. So, hallelujah, it was done. I know some of you are bummed in here, but TikTok has been banned from the U.S. app stores starting Sunday. Uh-oh. It's just going to create, like, a black market. Apple users are just going to, you know, bypass it, and then jailbreak iPhones. Probably going to cause more kids to jailbreak their iPhones. But WeChat as well. Supposedly no, you old, it's not like you can't use it, but oh, whoa. I got a bunch of tips. Hey, thank you for the tip, MMD. No problem, brother. Do be cook. Thank you so goddamn much, Tyler. You're amazing. I Chizek dollar? I don't know. I appreciate that. Zaki Raham, you should check out YFDAI, 7,700 circulating supply. Liquidity is locked, and the team is amazing. What I find funny right now is now the way to get a good-looking token is not a high supply. You know, it's low supply. Like, Yearn Finance is only, I think, 50,000. You know, we have a lot of projects coming out, you know, with these super, super small supplies. I don't know. There's a lot of copycats out there, so just be careful. Musher Munzur. Choo-choo. Thank you, man. You're the man. Kalis Anjuar. Does EDG have any short-term comings? The big thing for EDG would be launching on Kusama. I mean, that's why I love the Polkadot ecosystem, is there's a series of hype cycles that can happen. Because you have initially, of course, you know, the project building and test net, getting their own little mainnet out. Then they push over onto Kusama parachain, and then they actually push onto a Polkadot parachain. So all these ecosystem projects could have a hype cycle just from one big project going live. And EDG is big because it is a smart contract chain that will be utilized possibly by many of the different parachains and applications. Oh, Rocket Man, thank you. I appreciate it, brother. EWT Ocean Protocol video coming? We'll see. It's hard to really know what's going on with it, you know, the partnership. They have EWAI built, you know, or not built, but the concept, and I'm sure they're working on stuff right now. It's just hard to really cover, you know, what's not there yet. The partnership's there, they know they want to build together, it's just now they're building, you know? Uniswap V3 on xdai, they kind of have it right now. They're building it. Probably not going to be able. Yep, there it is. HoneySwap. Yeah, it got xdai, Compound, DAI on it, Gnosis, Honey, June, Lend, Link, Mana, Maker, Musigo, Stake, USDC. It's getting more tokens, and I'm pretty sure this was live on the mainnet. Pretty dang sure. So, yeah, I would use it for you guys, show you how fast it is. What I really like, xdai, I'm sure they're coming up with it, with the ERC-677 token for cheaper bridge transactions. Because they can use the burn and mint mechanism on both sides. So there is a possibility that... Yeah. And that's why I think a lot of tokens are going to actually transfer to ERC-677 eventually. And that's why xDAI just could become a bridge for that. You know, tokens, you want to become an ERC-677, come to xDAI. Transfer back as ERC-677 to the Ethereum main chain. But yeah, the one thing, you know, going... It all depends, really. I mean, if you have a transaction already, you know, you sent your tokens over to Ethereum, that's where you, or from Ethereum to xDAI, that's where you initially incur the most cost. If you want to come back from xDAI to Ethereum, it's literally nothing. Cheap as crap. PowerPool, DeFi, yeah, add on there. So, Andreas, I feel bad for the guy. I mean, he's been around crypto for a while. He's been helping push it forward. And now he's looking at Ethereum because of what is being built. It's awesome, you guys. I mean, if you don't see some of the power in it, I'm sorry. There's power in Bitcoin. There's power in Ethereum. But Bitcoin maxis, dude, they are nasty. They attacked him for supporting it. Like, he got hate, hate, hate. He's been called a cuck. FAG, beta, shatcoin, chiller, douche, idiot. Yeah, from the Bitcoin maxis. That sucks, you know. Come on, guys. And this, you know, I love Reddit. I've loved Reddit for a long time. I don't like the mods of our cryptocurrency. They kicked me off because I hated on VeChain one time. And some of the mods liked it. So they kicked me off. And there is a top post, ideas for generating our cryptocurrency moons demand, you know, the subreddit token. I got an idea. How about me? I mean, the more people know about it, the more people know what can be done with it, the better. That's what generates demand, you know, come on. I mean, a lot of people aren't even using their moons or know they have them or can get them because there's not much information regarding it. So, I mean, I'm actually, even though I shouldn't do this for our cryptocurrency because they literally kicked me off their freaking subreddit for no reason, I think I might make a moons video. Or I might make it for the Fortnite subreddit because they're the only one that has one too. Screw it, I'm doing it for Fortnite. Just to show what can be done. And it's actually through xDAI right now. Oh, yeah, so I'm actually, for the end of this episode, yeah, it's a surprise live stream Friday, so a short one. My normal days are tomorrow. It'll be much longer tomorrow, more involved. Would I? Jacob Shapiro, I've never heard of Plu, so I don't know. Liquidity vote, never heard of it. So if you guys haven't checked out Scotty P, he is the moderator, of the Chico chat, and he actually came to Chico recently. Now on to Chico. And me and Scotty, we chilled for the day, And he actually hooked it up with some Chico t-shirts. So I actually want to give away one of these t-shirts. Pretty cool, actually. I'm going to hold it up for you guys. We have, unfortunately, no smalls. So if you're tiny, you won't get it. But we do have medium, large, and extra large. And a woman's. So if a girl does win this, Chico Army's unstoppable on back. He made his own version of the equation. When you get it, I'm sure you'll get it. But yeah, we're going to do a giveaway. And it's like my normal giveaways. First person to answer correctly is going to win the shirt. Oh, JV. Shout out to the best crypto influencer. What do you think of Mantra DAO? Had a nice little hype cycle. A lot of the Polka projects did. I haven't got to look into it yet, personally. I've done an initial tiny dive, but not deep enough for me to make an informed decision. I appreciate your tip, man. I wish I could be of more help. Maybe an Ocean Protocol video then? Maybe. We'll see. I mean, I literally have no rhyme or reason to my videos, like what I'm going to put forward the next day. It's usually I wake up and I just start opening tabs and whatever hits my... So if you want me to do an ocean video, start putting out some good media. I don't know. It's hard to say because I do my research on different places. Have ocean people infect Reddit 4chan with good information though. So the giveaway. So for the Scotty P one of a kind crypto t-shirt, not an NFT like the few live streams we've done, it's an actual t-shirt. So you're gonna have to give me your address, which hope none of you are freaked out. I'm not gonna come kill you. John D, cheers from Europe. Learning a lot from you. Keep the fresh content. Keep helping people and stay transparent. Hodl on, guys. Chico Coin 2021. I'm actually thinking about doing a Chico Coin. Not an ICO or anything, but it will be a governance / utility coin for my website coming. Still in the initial thought stages, but... Okay, so let's get to the giveaway. So the first person to correctly answer wins the t-shirt. If you don't want it, I can give you some crypto, but I would recommend getting it because it's one of a kind, Scotty P. So the question is, with Uniswap, the distribution, of course, everyone got 400 tokens if you used it, but there was another way to get it. There was liquidity. Now there was a third way. What was it and how many tokens did you get? I knew someone was going to try to answer early because they saw it on it. What was it and... How many tokens? Oh, how many tokens it has to be? Nope, both. I gotta give it to FG. He said 1,000 for SOX holders. A lot of people just said SOX. A thousand per sock. Daniel, he said it before you. Yep, it's Daniel. That is correct, because that's basically the similar. A thousand for Unisox. So, I'm not going to hate on anyone because they didn't say Unisox. I know what you're talking about. So, 1,000 per sock. Daniel Brockwell. Daniel, your comment... on this video after the stream, send me an email. thechicocrypto@gmail.com. Can be found in the description of all videos. And we'll hook up and figure out the prize if you want a t-shirt. Congrats, man. Yeah, so, you guys, I brought up Unisox, too. One of the first crypto YouTubers to bring up Unisox. Did I get a pair? No, unfortunately. I just was, just like anyone else, you know, spending, when I first looked at Unisox, you know, I think they were like 100 and something a pair. Yeah. So I made a video on them, and some people actually did buy from my channel, because they jumped up to like 200 and something. Well, now they're at $2,755 a pair. They got up to like $3,200. You can buy and sell on here. So if you wanted to sell right now, you could actually sell your Unisox for $2,000. Well, yeah, I mean, if you watch my video, I mean, they were like 100 something, 200 bucks. And you got a free 1,000. I mean, they paid for themselves. I wish I bought some. Damn you, Tyler. All right, just getting to the tip. Sorry, guys. Oh, did I? I know there was a blue tip up there, and I just can't see it. Damn it. I'm gonna have to go look up here. Socks. Ah, it's not gonna let me get up there. Damn it, I know. I'm sorry I missed your tip, blue person. It was right before the socks came, and I was going to come back to it. Dude, how do we confirm Uni on Argent? 425 link? I don't know. Someone asked me that question already. I don't know how to confirm on Argent. I confirmed on Uniswap. When rareable Chico NFT? I've wanted to push out, you know, an NFT possibly, but not yet. I'm still waiting. I mean, I want to do mine right. I just don't want to push out. I mean, I made those first ones just, you know, as an experiment. So my experimental stuff, it could possibly be worth value one day. But when I really get my NFTs actual, I want to do it right and make them how they should be. I'm trying to do something like Unisox. So you'll see here soon. Good things take time, though. So, yeah, that's actually the stream, you guys. I appreciate everyone's tipping and stuff. How do we confirm when we're able? I appreciate your tip, too, Crypto and Culture. Damn, where's... Wow, Hagop Belarian. Thank you, Chico, you awesome. What do I think about Pinkion? I like Claros. I actually covered it. One DeFi, undervalued DeFi piece, because arbitration and those courts are going to be super valuable, especially as DAOs become a bigger concept, because you're going to have a lot of smart contract fights, and Claros, you know, is going to be able to fix things, you know, besides code, you know, arguments between people and things. So, that's very valuable, in my opinion. I appreciate it, man. You are amazing for that $100 tip. CLSLM, what's up, brother? Just live streaming. Chilling, you know? I'm so sick of DeFi, Travis. Travis, come on. Quit being a Travis, dude. You're being a total Travis right now. You just need to stop being a Travis. I'm kidding, Travis. But actually, oh, Crypto and Culture hooking it up with how to confirm on Argent. I knew someone out there had it. But Travis's I knew back in high school were Travis-like. They were like, I'm just so sick of this, you know? Let's go home. Yeah, and I think that's actually it for the stream, you guys. Appreciate everyone tuning in and tipping me. Early Saturday morning, or Friday, Saturday, Friday. It's not freaking Friday. Friday morning. I usually do mine on Saturday. So Saturday, I usually do those in the afternoon. So normal time. Actually, I do them around this time. Afternoon on the East Coast. Morning on the West Coast. A little. I give everyone time to wake up. But I do usually stream a little bit longer just to wrap things up on Theta. Link for that is in the description. So say hi to all the Theta viewers. They're tipping me on there and I'm just ignoring them. So come check me out on there. And I'll be seeing you guys next time. That is tomorrow. So probably I would buy xdai. That's my opinion. I'm going to have probably an xdai research video here soon too, because where is my ending? Jesus. Because I'm finding some things regarding Ethereum 2.0 that not necessarily xdai is going to be a... Yeah, xdai might be a big piece of Ethereum 2.0. Getting big looks by a lot of the Ethereum 2.0 devs. So, going to be good stuff. Peace out, everybody, and see you all on Theta or tomorrow.